In this podcast, we are going to discuss a simple technique that can help make teaching Shakespeare a little more fun and accessible for your students. When Shakespeare died in 1616, only about half of his plays were printed in book form, leading scholars to believe, much to their mortification, that Shakespeare appears to have cared little if his plays were published at all. But why wouldn't he care? The answer is because he saw his plays as plays, not as books. Unfortunately, we often tend to treat Shakespeare's works as though they were novels to be read rather than plays to be performed. Can you imagine if someone told you about a thrilling movie, then handed you the movie script to read? You would demand to see the movie itself. Yet this is often what we do with Shakespeare's works. Some teachers have begun moving away from including Shakespeare in their curriculums. But before we cut the bard entirely, one engaging method of teaching a Shakespearean play is by simply putting it on its feet. Teachers can help students understand and appreciate Shakespeare by literally having them perform some or all of the play. Using performance to dig into Shakespeare's plays is an engaging method for exploring a variety of skills and content. Not only do students have an opportunity to use the play for investigating a host of communication skills, but they also have a memorable experience doing it. Putting a play on its feet helps students consider questions they might not have otherwise. Such performances ask students to consider the tones, expressions, interactions, pauses, nonverbals, and character interpretations all implied through Shakespeare's beautiful language. Performance helps students see the variety of interpretations available, and they have to put themselves in the director's chair and decide how every line could look and sound. Instead of simply reading a play independently or from the comfort of their seats, ask students to stand up and act out the play as they go. Take your time engaging students with questions about interpretation, gestures, and performance. For many students, once they personally see and do the performance, the meaning behind Shakespeare's otherwise complex language becomes clear. Ask students to take turns acting out in front of the class or assign them into groups to develop performances of different scenes on their own. Putting a play on its feet isn't limited to having students act out scenes. This opens up the door for you to bring in films of professional Shakespeare performances. You can ask students to examine the choices of one scene from a performance, or consider showing the same scene from two separate performances and ask students to compare how each performance differs. Also consider how you might turn Shakespeare from a dry reading into a multimedia experience. Ask students to create film versions of assigned scenes, produce their own recordings of dramatic readings, create paraphrased parodies, design sets and costumes, compose music soundtracks, or artfully imitate Shakespeare's language. And, if possible, take your students to see a live Shakespeare play. Shakespeare, I'm sure, would roll over in his grave if he knew students everywhere were subjected to reading his works like a book. It's when we put his plays on their feet that they truly come alive. Let's help our students experience Shakespeare's plays as they were meant to be experienced, and then we'll enjoy increased engagement, skill development, and fun.